What's going on, YouTube? Ben here, player.net, and today I have something a little bit different for you, as you may notice. I have a little bit of an overview of a few different products from TT Esports. Now, we all know they make great peripherals, headsets, mice, keyboards, and whatnot, but they also make a lot of nice accessories to go along with it. So today, what I thought I would do is they kind of all go together, is I'm going to give you a quick look at their Pyrus gaming mouse pad, I believe it's called, the Hyperion headset holder, and also the Galaru mouse bungee. I feel all these products kind of tie in together, and you know, I think it'd be nice to show them off. So first, what we're gonna do is look at the Pyrus gaming mouse pad. Now, there's not a whole lot going on the box, but there is, of course, on one side, we can see the specifications, the dimensions of it. Lets us know it's got a rubberized design. We can, of course, see the TT Esports Dragon popping his head up all over the place. We've got a bit of information here on the back, and there's also a little thing here on one side. We can go ahead and feel it. So if we can go ahead and get this out, we'll just take a... put this box to the side. As we can see, it's nice and flat. There's a little warranty policy inside there. Don't worry too much when you first get it. If it's lifted up a little bit over time, it will smoothen itself out. Now, this is a nice mouse pad. I've got my Ventus mouse here. Glides across it with ease very nicely. So next up, let's take a quick look at the Galaru. That's how I pronounce it. If this is not pronounced right, I do apologize. But at the same time, if companies wanted us to pronounce their stuff right, I think they'd give us easier product names, right? Front of the box is a nice image of the mouse bungee. It gives us a few of the features that it has at the bottom there. And then on the back, again, is a few, a bit more specification features about it in various different languages. So let's go ahead, we'll get this set up real quick. It's definitely very heavy. Put those to the side, pardon me. It's got a nice weight to it, so you will not have to worry about it sliding around on your desk too much. Now, as we can see here, this is very easy to set up. It's actually got a magnet base on it. Once I can figure out how, and then this piece just, it sets in there. And I know some people are like, a mouse bungee, what does that do? Well, for me personally, I love them. What it does is it actually allows you to go ahead and put your mouse cord in here, and it keeps it set up on the back of, set up so you can have a nice bit to move your mouse around without having to worry about the cord getting caught on the back of the desk or anything similar like that. It's just a nice way to keep it up. You can set whatever length you want to make sure you've got enough room for your mouse. And at the same time, this is flexible, so if you do pull it a little bit too much, it will still move and has a bit of play with it. That's something, I know it's a bit of a niche product, but I, for one, love mouse bungees for my setup. I think they're great. Now, last but not least, we have the Hyperion headset holder. Now, this is another niche product, I guess you could say, and it's really just a good way to show off your headset. I mean, it shows it off, and it also does help keep it held up in place and protected a bit, so that way it's not on the desk getting knocked around or having things put on. It keeps them up and nice and kind of holds them the way things are meant to be held. Again, as you can see, the packaging on all three of these products kind of goes together, which, I mean, these products go together, so it makes a lot of sense. In the middle, we have a nice image of the Hyperion headset holder with a nice pair of TT Esports headset on there. There's, of course, the model number there. We got some branding up at the top here. And of course, it has their slogan on it, Challenge is the Game. Again, on the back, there's a quick diagram of how to go ahead and put it together. And then there's a little features list there in a few different languages. So let's go ahead, let's get this one out as well. As we can see, there appear, if I can get them out here, there appear to be five different pieces. Well, no, pardon me. Oh, wait. All right, this is a bit more than I was expecting, to be honest. It's in a nice, the inside, everything's packaged in a nice foam protected, nice and tight. Of course, our warranty policy again to make sure that we're all covered. Setup on this as well should be well, I always say it should be easy, but yeah. You take these, you line them up properly, give them a bit of a push down, and then you take these parts here, and there are a few spots on the back here where we can clip them into place, and it just goes ahead and makes sure that the plastic is a bit more secure. And it also, having them the way they were packed, allows it to flat pack it, make the box a little bit smaller. And I mean, here we go, this is it. There are, see the bottom comes off nice and easy. So if we need to take things apart, we can go ahead and do that. Or we can, hopefully we can just snap it back on. That's easy enough. But this is designed to go ahead and sit on our desk and hold our headset for us. As you can see, it does a great job of holding the Verto. The Verto headset, I believe it's called, yep. That's what it does. It helps keep things out of harm's way. And yeah, sorry, there's really not too much more to say about it. I mean, it's a good way to show your headset off, especially if you like to show your build off at shows and stuff. It's always nice to have some peripherals on deck as well. And it's just nice to keep everything the same. As you can see here, of course, we've got the Pyrus mouse mat, the Galaru mouse bungee, the Ventus mouse, the Hyperion headset holder, and the Verto headset itself, which is one of TT Esports' newest headsets out. That's pretty much it for this. I just wanted to give you guys a little bit of a closer look and show you that when everything is all nice to get, you know, it looks nice. I'm going to go ahead and do a bit more of an overview on this with some more pictures and whatnot to show you guys a few more different angles and a few different, like, how it would properly look set up with a monitor and a keyboard and all that. So please check back on player.net for that. Big thanks to my contacts at TT Esports for arranging this, sending me this stuff in to take a look at. It's greatly appreciated, and now that it's out of the boxes, it's going to find its way to my desk in about 10-15 minutes here. So again, thank you for that. Please like, subscribe, comment. All feedback is welcome, good or bad. Don't worry, we're not going to get mad at you. If you have some constructive criticism, please let me know. And again, yeah, thank you guys for watching. Please stay tuned in the future for more content.